Grixis is back. One of the things that people mention to me all the time, most frequently, where they know me from, is the coverage of Grand Prix Richmond. If you're not familiar with this, it was like kind of a special coverage event where they followed me through a Legacy Grand Prix and I played Grixis Control. People really enjoyed watching that and they really enjoyed the Grixis deck. I had been hesitant to bring it back into the equation for two reasons. Number one, Arkham's Astrolabe was legal for a long time and I kind of had this feeling of, well, why am I choosing Grixis when, you know, I can just play four colors for free and have all these basic lands and Arkham's Astrolabe is so strong. That card's banned. The other reason is Veil of Summer, which is kind of a beating against a Hymn to Turok deck. That's still legal, but for today, I'm just going to pretend it doesn't exist. Colony of Ants, good morning. Thank you for the sub. What I'm going to do is I'm going to play Grixis through a 5-round Legacy League on Magic Online. I'm going to record it as a video for the Channel Fireball YouTube channel. So I'll start by saying that this video and stream is proudly brought to you by the new Channel Fireball Marketplace. With hundreds of local game stores on the marketplace, you can find all of the sealed product and singles that you need to while buying from stores that support the community. So check out Channel Fireball today and start shopping. And please consider using code Reid, which does help support my stream and my content. Thanks also to Ultimate Guard. We are in the thick of the Ultimate Guard 12 days holiday giveaway. So please check out their website, Twitter account, online catalog. If you're with me live on stream, you can find some links to their stuff in either the panels below the stream or the chat. Okay, with that, let's get to some games. Can take a minute to talk about my deck list. I basically modeled this after the old Grand Prix Richmond deck, which was pretty well-tuned and well-constructed at the time. But there's been a lot of new printings since then, and a changing metagame, a lot of options to try out. So my approach was just, well, like I often do when I'm uncertain, is just try a lot of one-ofs. Cling to Dust, Unholy Heat, Nihil Spellbomb, Expressive Iteration, Murktide Regent. I think Gurmag Angler is a little bit outdated, which is a card I used to play. It is nice in the sense that it's a big threat. Doesn't get Lightning Bolted, doesn't get Elemental Blasted. But unfortunately, you know, if you need it to block, it's not blocking Delver, Dragon's Rage Channel, or anything along those lines. Okay, here goes nothing. Okay, we have Yorion right off the bat. My hand looks functional. Oh, good idea from Bazaar. Their Sudden Edict now exists. So I should probably, right now I have Liliana's Triumph. I used to have Diabolic Edict, but I should almost certainly try out Sudden Edict. That's a wonderful idea for next league. I'll make a written note of that. All right, my opponent's mulliganed to four cards, which that's something you often see out of like, you know, Reanimator or Dredge, but not something you usually see out of a Yorion Companion. I don't know, we'll see. Okay, we're probably looking at Death and Taxes. Unfortunately, I don't have anything proactive with which to punish this mulligan to four. Good question from Johan Leafhart in the chat. Even though it's three mana, wouldn't Soul Shatter be useful in case they have multiple creatures? It would, but I would just say that Legacy is a format that's so much based around efficiency that anytime you're spending three mana on an effect you could be getting for two mana, that's kind of a big deal. Hey, Steve Meyer, thank you so much for gifting those subs above and beyond the Call of Duty, but I do appreciate it. All right, we're pondering. We're trying to find some Hymn to Turox or Planeswalkers, something along those lines. Yeah, Jace the Mind Sculptor, that is just what we're looking for. It's a good warm-up, because, you know, people love this Grixis deck. I'm not sure if it's good, but I'll probably at least win the game that my opponent mulled to four and never cast any spells. Abundant Growth. Alright, you got it. I'm not going to try to mana screw anybody here. Legacy three times in a row. Yeah, I'm playing a lot of Legacy for at least the first half of December. That's my plan. My favorite constructed format. Okay, so here I'm going to draw Snapcaster Mage. Then I'm going to shuffle. And we'll endeavor to cast Jace the Mind Sculptor. Force of Negation, pitching Force of Will. I suppose I'll fight. And Brainstorm? Time Raveler. All right, you got the Time Raveler. So I know my top card's a fetch land. All right. Go with Brainstorm. Put back land. Fetch. Baleful Strix. You discard. And I shoot your Time Raveler. Mystic Sanctuary is another card I could try. Good idea. This deck does have pretty demanding mana requirements, but Mystic Sanctuary is quite powerful. So, notably, my opponent did not... Oh, they discarded the Abundant Growth. Sure. I guess I'm actually going to lead on Thoughtseize because the Inquisition could miss. Fascinating. All right, so I'm taking Brainstorm. Then I'm casting Inquisition. I'm going to respond with Quaddle right into my trap. It's a ponder and a no shuffle. Sure. Ponder and shuffle. Sure, brainstorm's fine. Yep. Leovold, okay. Well, Leovold plus Caracas is somewhat annoying. But I do have an answer to that. What I'm going to do is draw a card, bounce with Jace. My opponent will draw and then have the Leovold back in hand, and then I'll cast him to Turok. I feel like that's probably checkmate. Kind of just counter the next two spells my opponent plays. there's a lot you can do. I mean, basically at this point, like any mode that I use on Jace is so powerful. I can continue brainstorming. I can Fate Seal. I can bounce Snapcaster Mage back to my hand. But I say let's just get this game over with. Alright, my opponent has conceded. Definitely want max Pyroblasts. Could consider a Surgical for Uro. I think I want the Narset. So the question is kind of like, is any of this stuff better than Force of Will? I don't think I like Flusterstorm because it's so ineffective against the Planeswalkers. I could see one Bolt, one Surgical. Probably not Liliana's Triumph. All right, I like one Bolt. Could also trim the third K command. There's not really artifacts or small creatures, so it's more of just like slightly clunky value card. And I do love those. Let's try this. Wonder if I want Yorion in Grixis. Alright, so to ponder or to brainstorm? I think I'll ponder. Yep, I think I like everything that's going on there. Of your main phases, if you haven't added mana with this ability this turn, you may add X mana of any one color or X's number of islands target opponent controls. I guess I should probably try to Force of Will that. It worked, which means less likely to be a Veil of Summer. Nice. A good clean hymn to Torak. You love to see it. Yeah, I guess I allow that. Force of Negation, pitching Yorian. I'm going to force back. Yep. All right, my opponent has seen enough. Good showing, round one with Grixis. You're just getting into Legacy and you don't know what deck to choose. Any suggestions for someone who doesn't know the format? Well, I was playing Mono Red Burn yesterday. I said I think that deck is underrated. Interesting. Okay, I guess I lead on Delta, so I can't get wastelanded, but do have access to Brainstorm. Well, I could force it. I'm kind of inclined to just let it go, though. If I had known that I was going to brainstorm into Force of Will, I'd probably take an alternative line of fetch for Underground Sea, Force of Will, Atrenosphere, turn to him. But given that I searched for the island, I can't turn to him. I kind of have nothing if I pitch Baleful Strix to Force of Will. At the beginning of your upkeep, you may search your library for a curse card that doesn't have the same name as a curse, blah, 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 blah. Well, that sounds like it's going to be really bad for me. Ishu writes, I should have just fetched Underground Sea anyway because I don't care about Wasteland with that hand. Well, I definitely care about Wasteland if there's a Trinisphere on the battlefield. Wasteland is effectively Time Walk when my goal is to get up to three lands. Alright, well, I am just beyond dead here. Magicobo, 32 months. Thank you so much for the sub. All right. Sure. Chalice 1, yeah, that's fine. Not that strong against this deck. Plus I have Kolaghan's Command and Meltdown to get out from under it. Wow, that's a lot of Hagra Maulings. Okay, so during my end step, my opponent's going to make a 4-4 construct. How would I like to address that problem? I mean, I guess I'm just passing with Kolaghan's Command available and seeing what happens. I'll fetch all my lands right away so that I can't get unexpectedly needled. So the Retrofitter Foundry, you untap it, you sack a Thopter for a 4-4, you sack a Servo for a Thopter, and you pay 2 to create a Servo. A second Chalice for 1. Well, I think I'm just going to let you have your Chalice in that case and go destroy construct you discard. The key to winning this game will probably be finding Meltdown. Wow, that is awful. I'm gonna need some help and fast. I'm gonna need some help, like, immediately. Meltdown, Kolaghan's Command, Jace. Snapcaster Mage. Alright, Murktide Regent. So, I could throw 2 spells into the graveyard. And then make this thing a 7-7. I don't even know if that's really significant. Because it's not going to be able to fight the construct anyway. Well, I definitely don't care about Thoughtseize, so let's just throw the Thoughtseize into the Chalice. There could be a universe where I free up the lightning bolt and put that to good effect. I'm not dead to that construct, am I? I'm just gonna take like 8 damage. All right, a little help here. Maybe. Come on, Meltdown. Give me a Meltdown in my top 4 cards, please. Looks like I have to take Jace. Chump block with my 6/6 dragon. No big deal. Yeah, I mean, I can't force a will. I'm just dead. Notably, this can add mana because of Urborg. That's actually pretty useful. Come on, Narset. Where's that meltdown? I have two. I have two meltdowns. I'm actually pretty likely to win the game if I find one. Come on, Narset. Kolaghan's Command. So I can survive with that. I can go Jace, and then Kolaghan's Command destroys your construct, deals 2 to the servo. Let's see. I could also go Jace, bounce construct, and then Kolaghan's Command, deal 2 to servo, destroy Retrofitter Foundry, and then I'm stable at that point. Oh no! I didn't realize that they can make another. I just punted the game. Shoot. So I could have bought one more turn, and then got to activate Jace. So basically, what I should have done is Jace bounce construct. Then my opponent end of turn makes a servo. I go Kolaghan's Command, kill your 2 servos. Then I get to untap with Jace and see 4 more cards to find Meltdown. Yeah, I just miscounted my, like, I just didn't realize my opponent could make a servo end of turn. Now I have to see what I would have drawn. Alright. I would have bricked anyway. Not that that makes the play any better, but at least now I know. Bazaar asks, do I miss Sensei's Divining Top sometimes? Not really. I got my Sensei's Divining Top experience, and that was enough. Artifacts. So from playing these legacy leagues the last couple days, it feels like you just want your sideboard to be half graveyard hate and half artifact destruction. definitely paying for that. Multiple retrofitter foundries. It's a little extreme, don't you think? So I guess this is going to become another construct token. Should I just Force of Will? That's probably the first time in my life I Force of Will to Changeling Outcast. Draw. Right, so I think I'm going to cling the ponder and then go destroy construct you discard. Oh, actually, I should go destroy construct, pick up Baleful Strix, of course. Same thing, return Baleful Strix, destroy Foundry. give me a actual Liliana. That's what we need here. Wow, Ifano, thank you so much for gifting those subs. That's awesome. And if you were gifted a sub, you're awesome too. I'm happy to have you here. Hey, a successful Hymn to Turok this late in the game. But I still need some help or else I'm going to die to Retrofitter Foundry. This is one thing about the Grixis deck, is it's actually difficult to close out games. So even when you get ahead on resources, there can be no shortage of annoyances. And Alhammer, thank you for the sub. In retrospect, was pitching Jace to Force of Will a mistake? Well, there's nothing else to pitch to Force of Will, and the problem was Changeling Outcast can become a 4-4 construct with the Retrofitter Foundry, and I think the clock would have just been too great. I do wish I had Jace the Mind Sculptor in my hand right now. On that much we agree. And Regis, thank you also. A lot of subs today. I'm appreciating it. Alright, so I have to cling Brazen Borrower in order to survive this turn. But then I'm running pretty thin on outs also. It's a good start. That's a good start. One more. Two more, I guess. Kolaghan's command. Wow, so close. All right, that actually keeps me in it, I think. So I bolt this Thopter. No, I don't want to do that. I have to let this happen, then respond to the untap. So now I bolt the Thopter. I block the 2/4/4s, so I get to survive one more turn. I probably should have just thrown the Inquisition in the graveyard at some point in that game. To have one more card for Kling. Wow, Force of Will on the Brainstorm. Okay. So that's a ponder and a no shuffle and a changeling outcast, which I will try to lightning bolt. I mean, I could just save the lightning bolt because if my opponent's hand has Ingenious Infiltrator and Daze, then I want to be able to bolt the Infiltrator after it enters the battlefield. But that also might be like kind of overthinking things. I can also play around Ingenious Infiltrator plus Daze by beginning of combat Kolaghan's command. There's some weird stuff I can, some weird tricks I can pull. Baleful Strix works too. Just try to resolve the Kolaghan's command while I can. Sure. Yeah, I agree with the discussion in the chat. I think Plague Engineer is super strong in this matchup with the idea to name Servo. It automatically kills Changeling Outcasts. All that stuff's real good. Yep. Strix is down. Wait, I might have just done something different than what I said a moment ago. I said I was going to name Servo, but then I named Thopter. Yeah, I think the best name is Servo, and then Thopter and Bird and Ninja can all come up also, but I do wish I had named Servo there in case my opponent draws Retrofitter Foundry. Alright, I think I'm gonna pass and then draw step command to return my Baleful Strix. There's the foundry. Thank you. Yeah, I almost did play one Kroxa. That's a good suggestion. I ended up playing Murktide Regent and Cling to Dust as my sort of like Graveyard Matters cards, but I did consider Kroxa. I think it could be really good. Some suggestions that I should have brought in Narset. I could definitely get on board with that. Well, please, no infiltrator. Well, barring Daze, I get to get the last two cards out of my opponent's hand. Nice. This was really sharp by my opponent. They stacked the Ingenious Infiltrator on top of their library so that it would be protected against discard spells. I think I'm in a bit of trouble here.
Thank you.
Well, here comes Ambush Viper. That's the best I can do. Alright, I'm defeated on the mole to 5 nonetheless. Just the unanswered Genius Infiltrator is much too brutal. Well, it wouldn't be a Legacy League if I didn't face Reanimator at least once. Yeah, Vario asking about Sudden Edict in the chat. That was mentioned to me, and I just forgot that it existed when I built the deck. I think Sudden Edict would be better than Liliana's Triumph. I guess I'll end of turn brainstorm, just really trying to find interaction as quickly as possible. Oh, that is some interaction. Holy smokes. Look how good that brainstorm is. I'm almost getting excited like I could win game one against Reanimator. You think it's possible? Yeah, I mean, my opponent is kind of just dead in the water here. They need to draw, like, a discard spell and then an exhume. Eddie, thanks for the sub. Yeah, I really like one of Cling to Dust. I think it's perfect. It's a very subtle card, but you're usually happy to have access to it. And soon the Murktide region will come down and just be bigger than Grizzlebrand. unmask targeting Reader Rabbit. I think I'm gonna force of will this. Wait, their hand is just Entomb and Dark Ritual, right? Unless I somehow mistracked. Alright, sure. I'll just let this resolve. Oh, they exiled Entomb to unmask. Okay, thank you for correcting me there. So they have Dark Ritual and one unknown card. Well, it's actually a really good thing I didn't force the unmask. It would have worked out very badly. Step. Two damage and you discard. I don't think Reanimator really has enough instance to do anything after I make this play. So same thing, I think the Kolaghan's Command play is pretty safe during their draw step. They really do need to operate at sorcery speed. So they did have underground C, which means they could have show and tell after sideboarding. Definitely want surgicals. Definitely want Flusterstorm. And then these are sort of the marginal options. Yes to Narset. Few elemental blasts. And then, okay, Expressive Iteration is fine, because at least at worst it's a blue card for Force of Will. I don't think I can keep this on the draw. Now I'm down to six, so am I keeping a hand on the strength of a Brainstorm? I think I should probably go to five, just try to find Surgical Extraction. And I did. Hard to ask for a better five-card hand than this. Seized. This actually may not have been a good play to ponder there. Because if I do nothing, then I have Force of Will, blue card, and Flusterstorm. If I cast the ponder, it's like I have to take a blue source, which is not even really that good for me. And then I've one less layer of interaction. So I kind of regret casting the ponder. Should have waited at least one turn. So now I don't think I need to end of turn brainstorm. I'll just untap. I'll probably untap and main phase brainstorm. I like that. I don't want to tap out for Jace and put the shields down on Flusterstorm. Narset is interesting. Okay, I think I'm into it. I wonder if they're likely to have Pyroblast. Perfect. Did the reanimator player mulligan? They did not. They kept seven and they thought seized me, but they saw Flusterstorm and Force of Will, which is presumably why they're not going for anything. My opponents have taken a lot of mulligans in this league. Ironically, it was the reanimator player who kept seven both times. Alright, Jarvis, thank you so much for the sub. Thanks for being here. Jarvis is my official Legacy coach. Well, wouldn't be a Legacy League if I didn't face Reanimator at least two times. Do I Fatal Push or do I Ponder? I think I Ponder. Gamble. Okay. This is apparently not Reanimator. Basic, thank you so much. 24 months, that's awesome. Thanks for being here. Wow. What a beating. So brainstorm, kill Vengevine. wow, that just lets them pump the Ruwallas and then I'm dead. Incredible, incredible. Something like this. Keep the one mana discard for when I'm on the play. All right, let's do it. Underground Sea, Thought Seas. I think this hand's pretty bad. Like, it's definitely functional, but it just, there's nothing exciting about it. I'll keep this one. I guess I'll just pass with Brainstorm. Oof. I stopped the Vengevine, but I'm still getting double hollowed one. And I bottomed my Colgan's command. Okay, so my top card is a Thoughtseize. Pretty sure I want to ponder and Lightning Bolt, but in what order do I do things? Just start with ponder. Baleful Strix is definitely effective. Hang in there. Okay. Now we're talking. Destroy target artifact, pick up a creature. Angie's Ravager attacks each combat if able. Whenever it attacks, discard your hand, then draw three cards. You got it. Seems like a good Hydro Blast target. Ox of Agonis. That's actually troublesome. Good draw. Sure. I should have been holding lands. Oh, perfect timing on the Nile Spell Bomb. It's actually still a fine draw. Interesting. So I'm going to block the ox. Resolve damage and end of combat step spell bomb. Still need some help. Come on, something. Snapcaster Mage. Nope. Wow, I can't believe I lost that game. I made two significant errors. The first was spewing off my Surgical Extraction. I hadn't really taken the time to look at my opponent's deck list, but if I had Ox of Agonis on my radar, which I should have from seeing their deck from the previous Surgical Extraction, then I would have left that in my hand. And then the other thing was I should have just kept some lands in my hand, which would have benefited me either if I had drawn Brainstorm, which I did, or if my opponent had cast Burning Inquiry, which they did. So a couple of like subtle errors there that led to a winning position slipping out of my hands.